Hi, I'm Manfred Keene, the Bullard Thermal Imaging Training Instructor. In this training series of videos at Bullard, we are going to talk about the electronic thermal throttle. That electronic thermal throttle is available on all of our imagers except for the Eco-X. So again, it's an option on the LDX, it's an option on the T3X, it's standard on our T4X, option on our XT series, which is our QX and NXT imager. The electronic thermal throttle, again, don't confuse our modes. We have our super red hot colorization. So when I turn on my Bullard thermal imager, I'm in black and white grayscale, and then I get to my super red hot colorization, which is my yellow, my orange, my red. Don't confuse that with the electronic thermal throttle. The electronic thermal throttle is an investigative tool. It is going to give me a blue colorization of objects that are going to be below 500 degrees. Again, below 500 degrees. So if I take this imager, as I get off the truck and I activate my thermal throttle, and I go into a fire scene, that electronic thermal throttle overrides my high heat colorization. Everything becomes blue. That's not what I want. Again, thermal throttle activation on the T3, T4 series, two buttons on the top of the imager, press the bottom button down, activates my electronic thermal throttle. To turn off the thermal throttle, press both buttons down at the same time. Again, operation on the T3 and T4 series imager. What happens when I activate my electronic thermal throttle? I get the colorization of blue. I also get a TT number that's going to come in on the left-hand side of the screen. That TT number, it's not to confuse you, it's simply as a point of reference. So the lower is TT0, goes to the highest is TT99. So I'm going to give you for an example. I'm going to a structure, we've knocked the fire down, we're going in to do an overhaul, and I take my imager and I'm in my black and white grayscale mode, and I activate my thermal throttle, and that gives me a TT32. Okay, fine. But I continue to investigate around that structure within that room. I give it some time, let's say half an hour goes by, I turn off my thermal throttle, I point back to that same location again, turn on my thermal throttle, it now says TT20. What's that telling me as a firefighter? It is decreasing in temperature. So I don't have to worry about anything. I don't have to do anything. I don't have to create any unnecessary property damage to the structure. It is cooling down. But if I go in the first time and it says TT20, and I activate again the second time and it says TT32, that is telling me that it is starting to increase in temperature that I must investigate. So I get my tools out and I do my job. Again, T3, T4 series, activation of the thermal throttle, two buttons here on the top. When I get into my Eclipse series, which is my LDX and my XT series of my QX and NXT, operation is a little bit different. The Bullard name tag on the front of the imager, press on the left-hand side to turn on my thermal throttle, press both buttons down at the same time to turn off my thermal throttle. To adjust the sensitivity, I can continue to keep toggling on the left-hand side or right-hand side, which increases or decreases the sensitivity. Again, within the screen, blue colorization is your warmest that you're going to be investigating. Applications that we're going to be using this thermal throttle for, again, everything that is below 500 degrees for a special investigative tool, could be a size up when we roll in on scene, a missing person, could be a smells and bells calls, could be a hazmat situation, or overhaul to make sure that we put that fire out. So again, that electronic thermal throttle is available on all Bullard imagers except the Eco-X. Again, optional on the LDX, T3X, standard on the T4, and optional on the NX and QXT imagers. Please feel free to check out our other videos, which contains information on our options and features.